Hey, a pleasant good day, everybody. This is Sports Fanatic News. I'm Joe Boric. Unfortunately, it was a pleasant, or not a pleasant, ending result for our Lehigh Valley Phantoms last night as they lost 5-4 in one of those breakaway competition shootouts that J.J. Peterka was a star in-game and then a star in the shootout, along with Brett Murray was a star in-game for him, able to pot two goals. Brett Murray was as well. As just look very sharp on the ice, getting a couple more chances for the Rochester Americans against the Phantoms throughout the game, as well as J.J. Peterka, who was able to also pot an in-game goal, a key goal at that, the one that ended up getting banked off of the backboards, where this was a game that the first goal definitely was not on Sandstrom. That goal definitely was not on Sandstrom. The other Murray goal definitely was not on. This was just a game that there had ended up being four goals. And you can't really blame the goaltender for it, where sometimes when you look at stats, people go just from looking at numbers, well, the goalie should have stepped up more if he didn't see the game. Well, Weisbeck's on a breakaway, and he's one of the quicker skaters, has good hands. We saw that on that move. Brett Murray, who you expect to be a very good force as you're playing the Rochester Americans, was exactly that. And able to get two goals and able to really kind of just abuse the Phantoms and use his big body at 6'5", 227, according to AHL, and be able to just take advantage of Phantoms having smaller size guys, minus like the Isaac Ratcliffes of the world on the ice. So he was able to have a very good game. And then J.J. Peterka has skills, silky hands, and speed. He's going to be a good player, a very good player. Murray has a chance to be a good player for the Buffalo Sabres as well, whenever you have that size and ability. But Peterka has the very good, that's why they drafted him where they did. You knew this guy was going to be a stud, and he looks like he definitely is that. Hauser obviously was the backup goalie. The Phantoms were able to pester some shots on and take advantage of him a little bit. Like on the Jerry Mayhew goal, I feel like Ukko-Pekka Laikkanen might have controlled a rebound a little bit better and might have been in better positioning to be able to secure the rebound there. But as Hauser, I believe it was his first game of the season, and like I always say with goalies, reps are basically religion. You need to have them in order to be consistent. You can't expect a guy to come in and be very, 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 very good after he hasn't really played much, rightfully so, because they have one of the best goaltenders in the league in young Ukko-Pekka Laikkanen, who obviously the Sabres want them to play the most too, because he's going to be their goalie sooner rather than later when you have guys like Craig Anderson up there, and you have Dustin Gokarski, who's a great guy to have up there because he's worked his ass off to get all the way up to the NHL level. But this was a game that I really did like a lot of aspects of it, though, too. I didn't like the fact that we couldn't defend Brett Murray or J.J. Peterka whatsoever, but the fact that the Phantoms were able to really battle in this game, Morgan Frost continued to look good. York got an assist. Logan Day is one of my favorite guys to watch just because he's a simple, keep it simple Eddie. Does all the stuff you need to do, defenseman, and doesn't overcomplicate things. He was able to get an assist on that. Morgan Frost had a very nice wrist shot. He's a guy that probably, if Kevin Hayes continues to be out for a bit, Max Willman, of course, like the great Sam Wiseman pointed out, did very much earn his call-up. He's a great leader, has the A already in the AHL, and he's a guy that came up and has looked good at the NHL level, better than Nicholas Aubé-Kubel, who did score last night, so congratulations to him for the Avalanche, but better than how he looked when he was still on the team and then looked solid in his game the other night. He likely will be in the lineup this evening, and I have an article on him coming out on Flyers Nitty Gritty if you want to check that out. But the Phantoms, they did battle. Frost had a goal and an assist, which you love to see. Igor Zamula had another assist as he continues to progress his way up the ladder to get to the NHL ascension himself. So this was a game, yes, the Phantoms did lose, but they played a Rochester Americans team, like their announcer said, because when I rewatched the game, I was covering the Reading Royals last night, all I could get was their announcers to work on the AHL TV on demand. So, like they said, the Rochester Americans are a team that's a really solid team when they're going good, and then they have just kind of really off moments. They're kind of like our Reading Royals team in the ECHL, where they're a really solid team overall, but sometimes when they have their off moments, they're just off, and that's what costs them. They didn't have that oh so much in this game. It was more they just had meh moments that the Phantoms took advantage of, which I think is a very good sign for the Phantoms moving forward too, against an Americans team that's been really solid this year and has very talented players like Murray and Peterka, of course, on that team, as well as others like Weisbeck, excuse me, I almost called it Wellsbeck, Weisbeck, who's very solid as well. So This was a game that I think the Phantoms are going to be able to really take a lot of good from because they lost in a shootout. In a shootout, J.J. Peterka would be the first star of the game, was able to get a goal, and then a key goal to be able to have the fourth goal, of course, since Jerry Mayhew would have been the game-winning goal without that, plus then gets the shootout winner. Murray would be the second star, and I would say the third star of this game would go to our Lehigh Valley Phantoms, and that would be to Morgan Frost for the goal and the assist and continuing his hot streak this season and continuing his keen success this season. So this has been a reaction to the Phantoms' shootout loss to the Rochester Americans, but there's a lot of good, in my opinion, to take from that game because shootout losses in the really obviously come down to just a breakaway competition at that point, and that's why I hate them so much. But everybody have a great, safe, and pleasant day. Stay tuned for the preview to today's game that is coming up very soon. Just wanted to get this out here, obviously, first. Peace out, everybody, and go Phantoms. Let's get that win against the Marlies today.